Hello everybody, we're back with part 3 and 4. There'll be significantly less interrupting like there was in part 1 and part 2 because I've already explained pretty much everything I need to say, and this is just going to focus more now on cutting out and editing out most of the dead time and chaining together the best parts where Jason B.A.K.C. Interrogates and pulls the questions up for Jarnail Singh.
Or is it because at this time, December 2014, you would have continued to say what we've seen in all of the emails we've seen this morning, that sub-postmasters are guilty?
No.
To the extent to which they raise questions about Verizon, they're jumping on a bandwagon or acting to distract from their own guilt?
No, I've never held that view. Maybe in the email, that's how it comes across, but no, the answer is no, no, no.
Every email that we've looked at shows that you wrote that. There isn't a single email showing you held the opposite view.
Do you think?
Why is that?
I don't know. My answer is no. That's not the view I held from the outset. I never held that view. You're bringing this up over and over again, and my answer is no, no, and no.
Can you try and engage with the question rather than just say my answer is going to be no, no, and no?
Well, if you are repeating the same question 10 different times, the answer is going to be the same, isn't it?
If I'm doing anything wrong, the chairman will intervene. So kindly answer my question, Mr. Singh.
Okay.
If you held the view, if you had an open mind about the integrity of Horizon, rather than the view that we've seen expressed in countless emails now, why did you not reduce it to writing?
What do you mean?
Sorry?
Why did I put it in writing?
Why did you not put it in writing? If you had a genuinely open mind about Horizon, rather than everyone's guilty, if they blame Horizon, they're just jumping on a bandwagon, we'll win a few cases and those people will melt away like the midnight snow. Why do we not see any emails to say, look, I've got an open mind about this. We need properly to investigate it.
Because I'm not involved in that level. That's why. And I've never held that view. I will never hold that view. It's just unfortunate that I was sort of dragged into prosecuting these sort of cases, or this particular case.
Who dragged you in?
Well, it was my case, straightforward case, and it turned out to be quite complex and difficult case.
How did they drag you?
Well, they didn't drag me in that.
Why did you just say that they dragged you?
They were dragged in the sense that I was unfortunate to have this case that had all sorts of complications in it. I mean, if it wasn't a straightforward case, then you would have got somebody senior like, you know, Juliet McFarlane, who was the principal lawyer, or the head of criminal law.
Jarnail Singh, Jarnail Singh. That's what I'm calling him from now on. And he picks up them glasses and puts them down, but they never once hardly ever go on his face. I think they go on his head a few times, but he's just really combative. But thankfully, Jason Beer just gives it straight back and just shows up. I will just say, by the way, up until this point, look how clear his desk is. And this is going to be important for parts 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. And he already knows what his answers are going to be. His answers are going to be no, 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 no. But Jason Beer is not falling for it, and he's really holding him to task. You can't just say no to questions that not have been asked yet. As you can see, we've advanced for everyone in the video now, and he's walked into yet another cul-de-sac. He keeps saying that he always contacted Cartwright King with response to any sort of information that he could give to the BBC One show, who were about to do a show about the scandal. And he keeps saying over and over and over again, no, I did not write these emails that I sent and put my name on. I contacted Cartwright King first.
So we should be able to find an email exchange, should we, on all of these things, where you're going back to Cartwright King and saying, look, I've received this. Although I'm a senior criminal lawyer, I'm not expert in the criminal law. Can you help me out as to what I should say? Then we should be able to find a reply from Cartwright King saying, Jarnail, say this.
I don't know whether it be email or just me chatting to them.
and they're either dictating it or me making notes. I can't, you know, it's years later, tell you exactly what happened. But I presumably, if there is an email, you will be able to lay your hands on it, because, you know, it's there on the system wherever you got this one.
Well, that's the problem, it's not. What we've got is the email sent to you and then your reply saying my comments are as follows.
I don't know. I don't know what the answer to that, you know, this is years on. My thing is you just, I can't assist you further.
But you wouldn't associate yourself with this, would you?
Sorry to interrupt, I know you don't like me interrupting, but you see the shrug that Jarnail Singh did there is just really trying to get out of anything. He's really clearly in his body language being objective, and he really is trying really hard not to say anything, which takes up a lot of effort in the brain, but the body language always leaks out. Look at the hands clasped.
My thing is you just, I can't assist you further.
You wouldn't associate yourself with this, would you? That there's a case of a sub-postmaster blaming the Horizon system. Your response wouldn't be, well, hold on, there might be someone who said things under interview, under caution, in which they admitted dishonesty, and they're now misrepresenting the facts. Without knowing about a case, you wouldn't say that, would you?
No.
That's wild speculation, isn't it?
That's what it would be. But then it wouldn't be speculation in the sense that there may be some, you know, if you come across a case, you might have formed that view, you kept it, and then subsequently used it. But without any knowledge or personal experience, I wouldn't have just put it down to like that. And maybe the person who's helping and assisting in that case have come across it, and they highlighted it, and maybe rightly, wrongly, maybe I shouldn't have used it. I don't know.
All he ever does, I don't know, I wouldn't have said that, I wouldn't have done that. But he did do that, and you do that, and he did say that, and he did send that.
I can't say for the post office. I know certainly, I would, it's not my view, I didn't, you know, I did what
tapping
I had to
his
do.
His finger is nervous.
Even though you're the author of an email, which rather discloses that state of mind.
I may be the author of it, but as I said to you, that no individual person can do this. It's got to be a team effort, it's got to be a unit, because otherwise it wouldn't work.
You put your name to all of these emails. You weren't some naive ingenue, were you?
Probably. Looking in hindsight, maybe I was. Maybe didn't think it through. Maybe didn't have the time to think it through. Thinking through it now, I probably wouldn't have.
Can we turn, please, to poll
Oh, this is an email from Jarnail Singh to Susan Creighton.
And you say, I was thinking about what we've been working on, here are my thoughts. And you say, I was the prosecution lawyer in the case of the Crown against Misra at Guildford Crown Court in 2009-10. As far as I'm aware, this is the only criminal trial where a jury has been required to consider in detail the integrity of the Horizon system. I can say generally about what lessons can be learned from the case. Was this your own work?
No.
Here is my, here are my thoughts and what I am thinking. Did you write this email? No.
For mothers who know this, you know, who could assist with the...
So when you say, I am aware, I am seeking, and you're making tentative suggestions,
yeah,
that I have derived.
Yeah, I mean, looking in hindsight, I mean, that's probably would have been wise to say, look, maybe even name, say, look, I've sought advice from A, B, C, and D. These are the thoughts of a number of people, and that will help you in appointing, you know, the QC, Brian Altman, or who else, because this is the sort of area we're looking at, the complexity of the Horizon system, and you need to be aware of that, basically. I mean, I don't think there's anything in it. I mean, that's basically more or less what I done previously. So
you continue, Horizon is a complex computer system about which even eminent experts can make mistakes. Can you see, we've seen this before, haven't we?
Yeah, it's the same.
This is a rehash,
yes,
of another email.
Yes.
There was no reason to doubt Professor McClapham's expertise in good faith, and time again he had to be corrected. So here you're passing off as your own thoughts, a cut and paste of an email, which itself was passing off as your own thoughts, something that was in fact written by somebody else. Is that where we've got to?
It's, yes, I suppose you could say that, yes.
Well, I do say that, and I'm asking you. That's where we've got to.
I think, I mean, I was involved in it. I needed other people's input to do complete it. And this is just assisting legal counsel in the post office to help her to appoint somebody.
Can we scroll down, please? But where did that description of the dishonest sub-postmaster come from?
Just keeps picking up and putting down his glasses. I really wish there was someone just to take his glasses away, because he never uses them. You can zoom in on a computer screen. Take the glasses away. This is a good example of why I'm chaining together the best bits, because a lot of what Jarnail Singh does is this.
I think you're right. Probably was it more of a... I can't remember, to be honest. It just... I don't know. I mean, to answer that, I'd certainly... it was more, like I described to you, it's a relationship where they're basically... knew our work very well, but I think they've came on board on the postmaster's cases early year 2011.
That's what I was going to ask you. When did Cartwright King take over full responsibility for the lifetime of the criminal case?
I think more.
It just comes out with this word salad, and when he does say words, they don't actually mean anything. He's got a great talent, this Jarnail Singh, of saying absolutely nothing with lots of words. And great pause screen there for Jason Beer, because this is how you're watching it at home, isn't it? You're just watching with complete incredulity of how this Jarnail Singh managed to get any kind of qualification. And we all know by now, I mean, I've watched hours and hours of his testimony about just how he was just hired straight into Royal Mail Post Office with very little qualifications, and he gained his qualification whilst he was there. And it was a very useful fool.
It was very exhausting, it was very extending, but it was enjoyable in the sense it was something new. And the beauty, the good thing was that I had experts, Cartwright King, the barristers in Bell Yard, assisting and helping. So from a development point of view, it was quite good. But from
I'm less interested in your professional development, but more interested in and how fulfilled.
Well, I'm filling in purely because there was other things to do with it in-house. I mean, I can't list all of them because it was Susan, Hugh, other team members. You've got the civil litigation lawyers, again dealing with the mediation side of it.
So would this be right between March 2011 and April 2012, you were engaged in work that concerned the fallout from the discovery of some problems or potential problems with Horizon, and liaison with parts of the business concerning the second site review, the setting up of the mediation scheme, and other things like that, rather than the conduct of prosecutions?
The mediation and the setting up...
Never answers a bleeding question. What essentially I think Jason Beer is saying there is, so they've took off the work of you trying to deal with the court cases, because now you've been taken off that, they've freed up your time to try and defend Horizons still, because you've already made your point, even though you keep saying you're not making that point. But they're just on a Horizon bandwagon, bashing bandwagon. So now Jarnail Singh has lots of time to defend Horizon, even more time. Maybe that's why he finds it so much more thrilling, his job now, because he's got significantly less heavy work to do and lots of easy work to do.
So can you just help us? I'll ask one last time. As the person with a 15-year history of prosecuting cases, as the person who was the criminal lawyer, why after April 2012 did you have such a limited role, even though you were the only criminal lawyer in the legal team?
Yeah, that was what was required. It just fitted in whatever the business wanted. I mean, all of the prosecutions dealt with by outside. That's their model, or that's the way they wanted to go forward. And that's what the other areas of the law were. Same as the civil litigation. There was only Roderick, I think, there. And same as the company commercial. There was only one lawyer overseeing that. And that's the model. Maybe they misunderstood how it was going to work. But that's how it worked. And then subsequently other things took over.
Can I turn to prosecution policies and charging decisions?
Yeah.
He just became the useful donkey to sign off emails that he didn't even write, to try and put any kind of disparaging things about Horizon, just to put anything like that in the shadows. That's what he became. Jason Beer asked a question. It took this bloke 3 minutes to answer it. Here we go again.
Can I just get this right, Mr. Singh? In answer to my question, how over a 17-year period as a prosecution lawyer was your compliance with post office policy monitored? You've answered by defence lawyers.
No, that's one of the things I mentioned. And so, well, you know, you learn from it, don't you? As and when somebody's, reacting to it. But certainly it would be appraisals. I think every 3 months, every 6 months, I don't know what now. And certainly, we had conferences with barristers.
It just goes on and on like this.
Was it because people didn't view you as having expertise?
I can't tell what other people thought.
But surely it's the only criminal lawyer in the business. There's a suite of criminal law policies here. Wouldn't you put your hand up and say, hold on, that's my job?
I didn't, but maybe I should have done in hindsight.
You're not involved in any prosecutions, you told us. That's Cartwright King.
Yeah.
You're not involved in supervision of any prosecutions. That's
what
Susan Pugh. You're not involved in maintenance or review of the policies. That's Susan and Hugh. What were you doing?
Well, as you say, what I did do was that obviously picked up on various aspects of it, training of the investigation officer, which I did with Cartwright King. I was involved in getting Simon Clark to look at the prosecution policy. I was also involved in getting advices on auditors being, how the auditors ought to function, how they ought to deal with their role within the criminal law. There was so much there you would not believe. I didn't have. I mean, ideally,
list it then.
I would have. That's what I would have done. I would have basically taken over and then made it my own. But it,
in the words of Judge Judy, not basically. Tell me, what did you do? You could tell this was taxpayer funded, couldn't you? Because if it was any other business, he had very little to do there. That he'd have been sacked off or put on flexi-time or part-time at least. Why have they still kept him on as a full-time lawyer when everything had been palmed off to Cartwright King, a company which was clearly more worthy and useful to post office than this bloke?
You wanted to know, wanted it. Wanted them to be copied into it, so all I did, collected all of them, and sent it on to the relevant people to have a meeting on the 4th of February, and then subsequently, go through it and agree it, or not.
You were just a postbox, really. A collected together of pieces of paper.
Yeah, postbox in that aspect, but there was other aspect I was involved in as well. But yeah, I suppose in the realistically, maybe you're right. I agree.
Just a postbox.
Well, I wouldn't say just a postbox.
Look at that thing!
You say that.
Just a postbox.
Yes. Can we look, please, at poll 012?
Nothing went forward.
Mr. Singh, this does not say, please see below Chris's reply to Brian Altman's questions. It says, please see below Chris and my reply. It's your reply, isn't it?
It's my email, I suppose, but...
No, it's not just your email, because I wouldn't be asking you questions if this email just said, please see below Chris's reply.
Well, obviously...
I'm asking you the questions because it says Chris and my reply.
Well, because we discussed it. I mean, I obviously...
Was it not your reply, then?
Well, I'm working for an organisation. It's a joint sort of. He's the general counsel. He asked me to come and explain certain aspect of it, and I did. And then he said, well, Jarnail, I agree, I disagree. Jarnail, I don't understand point one, two of these questions. Or can you pose those two questions for Brian to clarify? That's my involvement in it. It wasn't something that I put forward or didn't put forward. I mean, it was not, you know, nothing since then. That maybe, that's it as far as I can help you with. I can't help you any more than that.
It's just more. Adam knows, can't remember, this form was a long time ago. But this is not a comfortable pose to be in, is it? He's got his hands clasped together, he's fiddling with his ring, he picks his glasses up, he's very tense. And it's... the next day, on December the 1st, which will be part 5, 6 and 7, 8... you'll see his reasons for not remembering changing completely. It's almost as if his solicitor has had a change of tactic of wanting to make him look as if he can't remember. I'm definitely hoping my video is less than 1 hour and 10 minutes up to this point. We're now into part 4. Can you spot the invisible piano?
So in the first of those instances where somebody had not raised an issue in interview or otherwise in a defence case statement or the like, you nonetheless believed it was important or necessary to be able to prove that the data produced by Horizon was accurate and reliable?
Yes, absolutely, yes.
And why was that?
Because it's it's a machine, isn't it? It's a machine. So there was a standard line I certainly put in, which I've, when I worked with the other people, when I did the advocacy or the barristers in conference, used that line always. And they always had somebody come back to say that it was properly working. It was properly, you know, high operated and it was working. I think there's two or three things I always used to put in, because it's a machine, it can go wrong. So we need somebody to say, look, how you operated, whether it worked or it didn't.
So it was your view that it was a necessary element of the prosecution case right from the beginning, irrespective of whether a prospective defendant had raised a Horizon integrity issue?
Well, it was a standard one that everybody agreed with and I used. I didn't look behind it, or maybe I should have done. That's what we did. And we had somebody, I don't know, who actually had a witness statement to that effect. And then, you know, subsequently, if it was raised like the Mrs. Miseret's case, it would have been investigated and further inquiries made and further documents obtained. But that's the way, you know, the our demise was structured.
How did you satisfy yourself that there was an actual loss in each case?
Well, the interview, then you had the...
the interview.
Interview in the sense that, you know, what's the postmaster's explanation, what he's saying, then you... Firstly, it was the auditors. Auditors would go in and they would sort of audit the, the branch, and they find a shortage. Then it was the interview. Then it was the operation of the system itself. Then you had witness statements, the access, who actually put the figures on the system itself. You know, that's the sort of evidential side of it I would have looked at initially. Then as the matter progressed, you got more and more evidence as to it.
Was audit data or were transaction logs sought as part of the initial investigation or only if the sub-postmaster raised the Horizon integrity issue?
Looking back on it now, I think that was essentially done, they should have been done right from the outset.
Sleeve pull!
But it wasn't. That was if the supposed must have raised the issue, or subsequently Section 8 application, or that's when it was triggered off. But those are the way the case actually progressed from the outset.
Sleeve
and then pull. As and when the case progressed, the further evidence, the horizon issues, if they came about, that's when the data transaction logs were requested. But they weren't requested by me. I requested it from the investigation officer. The investigation officer obtained it from whoever, and now we know where they should have got it, and maybe they should have got it from the outset. I don't know. But we didn't at that stage, at that time.
Another long, long, long answer to a very short, clear question.
That's what we did. I mean, if I put it like that, how could I actually say that? I can't say that, can I? This is how we worked. This is how we did things from year 2000 to year 2012. I mean, if I put, all that sort of thing, you'd be taking me to the contrary view. You didn't do it. Why didn't you do it, Mr. Blakey? Why didn't, maybe I'm saying too much, but I do feel it very strongly. I do feel really hurt that we let 12 years go by and nobody picked that up. That where are the RRQ? How the hell are we proving this?
I think
this?
It's right, therefore, as you tell us, I'm not going to ask for these to be put up, but it's paragraphs 89, 109, 123 and 146, that audit data was not requested in a number of criminal proceedings which ended up in a conviction.
Please explain to me, it's late in the day, not as young as I used to be, that say that again and slowly,
so
please.
You tell us in passages in your witness statement when you're referring to case studies that we're looking at.
Yes.
It's paragraphs 89, 109, 123 and 146, so four cases.
Yeah.
That audit data was not requested in criminal proceedings.
Is that what I say? Where did I say that audit data?
Well, let's have a look, if you want to look at it.
Are you talking about whatever it is, AQ, whatever it is.
ARQ data. Paragraph 89.
89, sorry, yeah. Hang on.
All of a sudden, Jarnail Singh wanted to be all methodical. So even though Jason B didn't want to waste time pulling up the individual cases that he'd looked into, Jason B had been Jason B, as thought, well, right, okay, then you want to be methodical. Look, is what I saw. No horizon data was requested from Fujitsu in this case, and it's just gone through all four of them.
So in these cases, and there are many, many more,
yes,
the post office did not obtain audit data, correct?
Yes, correct.
Thank you, that can come down.
As you can see now, we're fastly approaching the end of the day's questioning, and what we've got so far is starting to... I thought he only started this, I forgot that he said it at this part of his testimony, that his age, it's late in the day. It's 4 o'clock in the afternoon, And it keeps going round in circles. But this is the point where this might explain why he's so roundy, flip-floppy, going round the houses, getting stuck in cul-de-sacs. It's because he's waiting for his solicitor. I forgot... His solicitor, he's expecting his solicitor to constantly chip in, but she isn't at this moment. She doesn't do it at all today, I don't think. It's tomorrow when she does, on the December the 1st. Anyway, this is just proof of that.
You tell us in your witness statement, it's paragraph 256, that you played a role in obtaining the audit data in the criminal proceedings against Mrs. Misera, because it was required by the investigation security team, okay?
2156.
Again, I'm sure your solicitor will say something if I mis-summarise.
I take it. Sorry about that. Yes,
It slows us down if every time we have to go...
Sorry, of course.
I'm just summarising so we don't have to get it up on the screen. Tell us that you played a role in obtaining the audit data in the criminal proceedings against Mrs. Misera, because it was required by the investigation and security team, okay?
Yes.
Can we look, please, at UKGI 001-4895, please? Solicitor, Izzy Hogg, to you. saying we refer to Judge Critchlow's order. There's a problem with their office system. We enclose a request for disclosure, third paragraph. We note that your response makes a suggestion that our expert meets with your investigating officer and representatives of Fujitsu. Can we endorse that and emphasise that we have, since July last year, been requesting that our expert has access to data records, a request that has been repeatedly rebuffed on grounds of cost and the work involved. But why was the Post Office refusing to provide Mrs. Misra's defence expert with access to audit data?
I don't know now, but I certainly it was out of my hands. I think I did as much as I could. But then it was that contractual, commercial relationship that the Post Office had with Fujitsu, but it wasn't something that I didn't want or obstructing. I mean, obviously, I'm the lawyer in the case. I did all I could to progress it, help it along. But you
knew that the only way to test whether a problem had arisen at a particular office was for a detailed analysis to be undertaken of the relevant transaction logs, the audit data at a particular branch, didn't you?
Yes, I accept that. But I mean, it was not lack of trying and not obtaining it. I wanted to obtain it. I mean, I think if you go back, September, October, November, the first thing I did was to actually copied in the investigation and said, look, this is what the defence want disclosed. This is their inquiries. Please deal with it. And then I think subsequently, the matters transpired. It did.
And if we fast forward a couple of years, 3 years or so, to poll 306-0974. And look at page 3, please. It's the bottom of page 2. Can we scroll down, please? 4 lines up from the bottom, you say the only way to test whether a problem has arisen at a particular office is for a detailed analysis of the relevant transaction logs to be undertaken, as happened in the Misra case. And then over the page, I imagine the independent inquirer will be examining some, perhaps all, of the cases on Second Sight's requested schedule. In none of these cases were the transaction logs ever examined? This is time-consuming, expensive, though it may be the only way to investigate the concerns raised by these former sub-postmasters. So you knew that the only way to test whether a problem had arisen at a branch was for a detailed analysis of the transaction logs,
yes,
didn't you?
Well, I said so, black and white.
So if that was the only way to test whether there were horizon issues at a branch, why wasn't that obtained in each investigation and in each prosecution case?
Operated. That's the way they dealt with it, like I previously advised, as I previously told you.
Do you accept that expense and time is not a sufficient reason to obtain the audit data if it was the only way to determine whether there were problems at a branch?
That the expense and the time-consuming bit didn't affect me at all. I wanted it.
An answer to a different question. Do you accept that time and expense is not a reason?
No, it's no reason.
To not obtain the data?
No, but somebody's liberty at stake and the other things I read from the impact statements, no.
Okay, we'll go back to the story then, back in February 2010.
Yes.
FUJ00122713.
That concludes November the 30th, and that part 3 and part 4 of this run of videos. If you're a new subscriber, because randomly YouTube decided to promote the previous videos, so I'm rather chuffed about that, I'm going to put it into a playlist so you can watch it, because I don't just do YouTube videos about the Post Office inquiry. There's loads of other stuff because my channel is quite varied. As I've always thought, a channel was always meant to be So there will be a playlist for the Post Office Inquiry Horizon Fujitsu thing.